Hey, what is up, YouTube Rules for Rebels here. It is January 11th, early in the morning here. Bitcoin is down to 798, actually just ticked up to $799. It's been a pretty crazy 2 weeks for Bitcoin. I was meaning to make a video the other week when it spiked to over 1100 and over, I think it was overnight, right? Yeah, over, let's see, as of today, even January 11th, it was at 915, and it just totally tanked and crashed. I think we were down as low as 788. Let's look at the chart here. So it seems like we're creeping back up. I think we may go back down. But if you're looking for a buying opportunity, I'm not telling you guys to get down now, get in now. For all I know, Bitcoin could drop to 500 bucks. But let's just take a look at the chart here. So if we look at the past week, we were as high as 1149. We dropped down to about 819, had a little bit of a recovery, and then overnight we had another steep drop. So what I don't like to see here is if we had a drop and people said, hey, this is a buying opportunity, I'd like to see the chart trending back upwards. But as you can see, it picked up a little bit. We had some buyers come in, kind of a leveling off, and then another tank. So I typically notice about three drops, so I wouldn't be surprised if we get another drop down to 750, maybe even $700. I'm not that freaked out, just because most of, some of my Bitcoin purchases I'm sitting on right now, I purchased for, I think, as low as $280, others 300, others 400. To date, my highest purchase was actually one I made today. And I actually bought in today at 816. That's actually including Coinbase's markup. So I think the official Bitcoin price at that time was about 812. So I mean, right now I'm down about 10 bucks per coin. Like I said, I mean, I'm not really freaking out, because in general, I'm up quite a bit on my Bitcoins. Most of my Bitcoins I'm holding anywhere from 280 to say 650, 700, 750. I do have a purchase from about 2 weeks ago at 812. So I'm down a little bit on that, and down, I just purchased probably 10 minutes ago. So I'm down about 10 bucks on a purchase I just made. But I personally think, my thought is that we're gonna have a little bit of a recovery. I think we'll probably shoot back up to 860 or so. I'll probably sell off my coins and just do a swing trade and maybe make a quick 60 bucks a coin or something like that. I'm kind of kicking myself for not selling at, what was it, at 1150. I wish I would have sold at 1150 and then used, this opportunity to buy back in at like 833 or even 800 now. But Bitcoin was going through the roof. My thoughts was like, wow, is Bitcoin about to take off and go to like 3 grand a coin? I don't want to miss out. So I bought in. I'm sitting down a little bit on my Bitcoins. Overall, I'm still way up and way ahead. As far as the reason for this crash this morning, so after we saw the drop from like 1150 down to 880, 900, for a couple days, it was actually looking like Bitcoin had kind of stabilized around that price, and maybe that was going to be the bottom, and we would slowly see a climb back up to maybe that, $1,000, $1,100 mark. However, yesterday or early this morning, it was announced that apparently China is investigating some Bitcoin companies for like money laundering, for market manipulation, etc. And I think that's what has caused this recent drop, which is why, overnight we went from like 914 down to, 803. And I think now we're even down to 794. Now, keep in mind, even though we've had some crazy drops, personally, I wasn't really buying in at the $1,000 or $1,100 mark. I kind of stopped buying previously at about 812. So I potentially could have made some money if I would have sold off here. I was kind of greedy. I didn't sell off. But even as we stand now, I mean, I'm really kind of right around even on even my highest Bitcoin purchases, which were made more recently. Like I said, the older purchases, I'm still up on quite a bit. But I wouldn't be shocked if we see Bitcoin go down to about 740 or so. Like I said, I just bought some this morning at 816. I think, with the prices drop, the same way that when prices go up, people take some profits. When prices fall really quickly, a lot of people see that as a buying opportunity, or see it as a chance to get some Bitcoins at a discount. So what I'm hoping happens, and what I'm kind of thinking that's going to happen, which is why I made my purchase this morning, I bought in at 812. I could have bought it a little bit cheaper, but you never really are able to catch a falling knife. You're never going to pick the bottom. So I just picked a price that I thought was good. I think in the next couple days, we're going to see Bitcoin shoot up to like 860, 880. I'm probably going to sell off at that point, because I think we'll see another pullback. And I think we're going to see Bitcoin price flatten out at around 840 or so over the next week or two. I'm actually using an app called, let me see what it's called. I'm actually using an app called Bitcoin Alert. There's a bunch of different ones on the market. I use Coinbase, and Coinbase doesn't allow you to set like limit orders or market orders. I'll let you guys look at the 30-day chart while I ramble here. So I need some way of keeping track. It's kind of crazy. My buddy told me I came into work the or came into the office the other day. My buddy tells me, he's like, "Did you see Bitcoin's at like 1150?" I'm like, "Oh shit, I didn't even know." Like, if you take your eyes off Bitcoin for even half a day, the price could swing hundreds of dollars. As we can see here. So on what here we're December 18th, by January 4th, I guess that's a decent amount, but 18th to the 25th, we went from 790 to 894. December 25th, Christmas, to the 4th of January, went up to 1129. And then what is it? Literally 2 days later, we were back down at 895. And then here, as of today, even yesterday, we were at 904, and now we dropped 100 bucks. So, I mean, it does swing wildly. So I use an app called Bitcoin Alert. Like I said, just go to the App Store or the Apple Store. You can download your own, and you can set alerts for, okay, when the price drops to 850, I want to get a notification, or when the price drops 20%, I want to get a notification. And the purpose of this, or why I find this valuable, is A, if I think Bitcoin's going to come down and I'm waiting for a buying opportunity, I can set an alert. So let's say I think Bitcoin's going to fall. I can set an alert for like 780, and I want to be notified. My phone will go off when it hits 780, and then I know to log on to Coinbase and purchase. On the flip side, if you think Bitcoin's going to have a sharp increase and you basically just want to make a swing trade, if I, like I said, I think Bitcoin's going to shoot up to like 860 over the next couple of days. So I can set an alarm for 860. So as soon as that alarm goes off, or if it goes off, I can hop onto Coinbase, sell some coins, and make a quick 60 bucks a coin or whatever it may be. So basically, guys, my message is don't freak out. The sky is not falling. Bitcoin's kind of volatile. Things swing a lot. This is why we like it. I still feel the long-term value of Bitcoin is coming up. Anytime an exchange gets hacked or there's talk of market manipulation, things go crazy and it tanks, but it typically tends to recover pretty quickly. I ideally would like to keep all my buys at $800 or below. I really wasn't even that comfortable buying in at 812, but then we saw it shoot up to 1150 or whatever. As far as like I said, why it's falling, China's investigating some exchanges and some miners for market manipulation and things like that. I think this is a short-term decline. Maybe that jump up to 1150 was kind of artificial based on some market manipulation, but I still don't think that really affects the long-term value of Bitcoin or the utility of Bitcoin. If you got in 2016, we saw the market go up over 120%. Even in just the first 3 days of trading, in 2017, we saw a 20% rally. So, the sky isn't falling. This really is just kind of a pullback. But I'm curious to hear your guys' thoughts. I know I made a video a couple weeks ago about Bitcoin. What do you think about the giant, like I said, I haven't made a video since it shot from like 800 up to 1150. So what do you guys think about the big increase? Did you guys make some money? Did you sell off, or did you hang on? What do you think about the crash? Are you freaking out? Do you see this as a buying opportunity? Let me know what you guys think. Drop a comment in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're not subscribed, please hit that subscribe button, and check back for more videos, guys. I got some good stuff coming out this week. Talk to you guys later.